Barry Katz in the room, which is good because we don't want anybody here that's hated more than Patrice. Carrie Kravis couldn't make it. She said she had to work in Vegas. I didn't know her brother owned a restaurant out there. And little Kev is in here. He's in L.A. filming a movie. I think it's called Lawn Jockey. Oh, did he do a color joke? Fucking great. Listen, I know, I'm not going to forget, you fucking mess. This fucking idiot would have wore a fucking suit, but he couldn't find one with a team logo on it. You know, it's funny, when you roast somebody, it's because maybe it's their birthday, or they accomplished something big in the business, or you just don't like them. When I look at fucking Patrice, I think of five of the seven deadly sins. You know, I don't want to talk about his fucking weight, but his car has stretch marks. This fucking fat fuck should have his kitchen stapled. Yeah. Yeah. You ever see when black guys, when they drive and they lean to be cool? He does it to keep his car level. Patrice, though, his career is doing fucking well, man. You can't deny that. He was in a Spike Lee movie. He was in a Meg Ryan movie. My favorite piece of work is that movie he was in with Sigourney Weaver, where you couldn't see him through the mist. Folks, if you really want to see how much people can't stand this fucking guy, go to the Tough Crowd message board. All right? Richard Speck is more liked amongst nurses. Wasn't that a good one?
You can't be clever, just be stupid.
Okay. Thank you. Jesus, now you got to sit next to him to kiss up? You fucking zero. Jesus, a year ago he would have been between Opie and Anthony. Jesus Christ. How the fuck? You bandwagon jumping douchebag. You fucking, holy shit, Jesus Christ. And I don't want to smell your breath because it tastes like Dice's dick. He's a fucking, he's a marshmallow.
Hello, you fucking asshole.
Opie who? Oh, no, I'm doing Stern this week. You fucking sellout cocksucker. Here's a queen. He walked by O&A like people walk by DC Benny after one of DC shows. Oh, that was fucking unbelievable. All right, we're gonna get to it. Wait, hold on. Let me see what we got first here. This is gonna be fun. You are so lucky to have me host this. I am too fucking big for this bullshit. Hey, singer, I'm open next week. Fucking Jeff can't even believe the job he has. You call him at work and he answers the phone. Three arts. First act, in a second, we're going to bring Bobby Kelly to the stage. Bobby Kelly's career is so bad, Steve Byrne bumped him the other night. watch fucking Bobby perform, I wanted to quit the business. All right, they're not all killers. How do I follow that fucking Norton tyrant? Shut up. Bobby likes to eat, you can see. He sent me a fucking email with gravy on it. The other night, I know I can't fucking, I'm a mess here. I know. What do you call it? the other night, Bobby and Billy were at the cellar, Bobby and Billy Byrne, they were talking. I really didn't hear what they said, but I did hear Rutgers, Florida State, 750 after commission. And people would think, as big and fucking pathetic as Bobby is, that he's a lazy guy, but he's not. He sold more of Dane Cook's CDs after the show than any other Dane's openers. Bobby's going to come up here and make this podium look like a mic stand. A big hand for Bobby Kelly, folks.
You really fucking stink. I fucking don't like you.
Don't kill the microphone.
I fucking lost weight, you asshole. Fucking douchebag. He doesn't even fit in the fucking chair. What the fuck? Oh, Jesus. Ugh. We were going to have this roast over at the Comedy Cellar, but they were sold out 3 shows, so we knew this fucking place was empty. Manny, that was for you. I have to have spots. Fuck off. Give me that, you douchebag. I'm not fucking Greg Giraldo. I need these.
Sold out to me, motherfucker.
Here, stupid.
You're not great because he does TV.
I did the show once. Fucking douchebag.
That's a key word, once.
I really can't. You know, Colin, you and Norton, you were all finished, and then Colin had to get a show and bring you all back on the fucking map. You Dr. Frankenstein. Go fuck yourself. Opie and Anthony was gone. He was going to jump out a window after sucking a transvestite's cock. This douchebag was going to go coach his girls' softball team. This fatso was going to fucking eat himself into fucking coma. And you had to get a show. Fuck you and fuck you, singer. Suck a dick.
Jeff, that was his audition for Tough Crowd. How do you do?
What's up, Jeff? Fucking Jason Steinberg's here. Jesus Christ, Jason. Isn't my career shitty enough for you to manage me? Why am I being managed by you? I'm at the end. Come on. Did you get my tape? Fucking clientele sucks. What are you doing? What the fuck is wrong with you? Jim Norton, fucking good friend of mine. He's just fucking. Jim, I love you, but you're awful. He's got a body. He looks like an angry thumb, doesn't he? He's the only guy I know that pees lying down. That's the only way you can get it in your mouth. Okay. Yeah? Okay, whatever. Why are you fucking tan all the time? You go to the tanning salons, right?
No, I work on the road headlining and I play golf.
What are you, golf naked, you fucking moron? You have... Douchebag. I shouldn't have cut that off. That was pretty funny, right? Look at your teeth. Ugh. Well, listen. I actually, you know, we're here roasting them and you know, everybody, we're all friends of Patrice, but actually I wanted to get a couple people that couldn't be on the roast that really, you know, the open micers and the people that this fucking moron has fucked with on a daily basis. I'd actually wanted to hear what they had to say, so I got my camera and I took a couple video things here. I want to show you, just to see what people really, really fucking think about this ass.
And you know, you don't give a fuck. It's not your birthday. You find me in the club. Bottle full of bubbles.
You look like shit in that picture.
Hey, how you doing? You know Patrice, right?
Unfortunately.
Yeah. What do you think about Patrice's comedy? Do you think it's you know, trite. Is that what you think?
That would be the word I'd use.
Really?
Yeah.
That's all right, man. I mean, if you like that kind of witty, I'm laughing at my shit type comedy, you know what I'm saying? But, you know what I'm saying? I'm coming to the black club. I want more, you know, and all that shit. He don't bring her there.
Why is that?
He's scared.
He's scared of the black ropes?
Yeah. Why? I mean, he tried to do it once. He went out and bought some outfits.
What do you think? Do you think he's up there? Do you think he's going to be up there with Carlin and Pryor and you know, Eddie Murphy? Like, do you think he's that funny?
No, Pryor, bro.
Carlin and Pryor?
Do you think his comedy is, like, amazing? Do you think he's one of the best comics?
The best pussy jokes I've ever seen in my life.
What do you think about the rest of his act?
That is his act. Rubbing his chin.
Do you ever make fun of you personally?
Yeah.
Does that feel good?
It's embarrassing at times. I mean, he once said that I don't look like I wear nice panties. The first time I met Patrice, I was really excited to meet him, and I introduced myself, and he couldn't even touch me. He made his girlfriend touch me because I'm a white girl, and he doesn't like white people. He even said white girls have cooties.
Hey, Patrice, Tom Herrera, your elder. Like, you know, it's funny to have a chance to be as good as me. Because I fucking got something silverback. Let me tell you something. Thanks a lot for letting me talk about your mom today on your show. That was called Colin Quinn, tough crowd. But you never showed me what a fucking filibuster.
I don't know, he's supposed to be all this and that, but he has to go to another country to get laid.
I want you to sum up Patrice and me on like one or two words.
Diabetic coma.
That
fucking hack.
Patrice O'Neal? It's a big fucking closet case. Yeah, I really got nothing to say about Patrice, man. The only thing I can say about Patrice is he's like the comedy fucking gooch. He's a fucking big bully, and when he has a haircut, the back of his head looks like a fucking Shih Tzu puppy. That's all I got to say about him. Fuck him.
Fuck that nigga, yo. Fuck Patrice, yo.
Yeah.
Fat motherfucker. I wish that nigga run up on me, yo.
And another thing. You know what else pisses me off about you? Your attitude in Montreal. French love Jerry Lewis and they fucking hate you.
He's fucking vicious. He's a vicious fucking prick. He's just a sad, fat, bitter fucking man.
Long, emotionally cut off. Verbose.
You know, Patrice, the difference between this roast and other roast is that most of the time roasts are done in the spirit of good fun. We're making fun of you, but we really don't mean it. The difference with this roast is everybody really hates you.
I think he's the fungus of the comedy community. Syphilis, gonorrhea, herpes, AIDS, all fucking festering together. He's the only thing funny about him is the fat fucking rolls on the back of his neck, the fucking sweat that comes off it, that is filled with buffalo wing sauce. He's fucking dick. He's an asshole. He's a cunt. He's got the likability of Josh Speer. He's the Uncle Tom on Colin Quinn's show. He's an asshole. He's a dick he'll never find because he's just one big fat fucking cunt.
I think the roasts are pretty disrespectful and I don't really go into them and dig them. But Patrice, two words, fat nigger.
I didn't say it. That was Hood. That was funny, right? All the white people went, oh. I got, you know, this is Patrice's roast. I just want to say one more thing. I did this other thing. Actually, I just wanted to show you this. A friend of mine, Steve Burns. You guys know Steve Burns, real funny comic, right? You guys like Steve? Well, he actually borrowed my camera like a year ago to, he had to do an SNL audition, and you have to tape yourself doing characters, and he actually gave me the camera back and left the tape in the camera. And I thought you guys might get a kick out of it like I did 57 times at my house.
Yeah!
deaf too.
Oh my God.
He's dead serious.
You and I'm Rose Decay.
You have to see this last one. You guys might enjoy that. That's it. Patrice, congratulations on fucking absolutely nothing. Goodbye.
Hey, Bobby. Hey, Bobby.
Hey. What?
Did he get it?
Did he get the tape?
Did he get SNL?
Well, he's hosting at the Cellar tonight.
Greg wrote that question last night. A big hand for Bobby Kelly. I know. This is the first time Bobby's been on stage without fucking a chair. Fucking Kyle Grooms is going to use that as a TV credit. Yeah, we can't forget our my manager, Jason and Evan, are here, so I got to give them a little play. Do you ever think Evan looks at Jason and says, "Tell me about the rabbits"? Jason manages so many black comics, he shares an office with the ACLU. Jason is so fucking cheap, he charges commissions on callbacks. That was fucking funny, you fucks. Look at that. That way, Bobby, another hand for Bobby Kelly. That was really funny, Bobby. That's... All right, let's see, who do we got here next? Look at this fucking lineup. I think we got DC, let's see. What's that, turn the mic up? Can they turn the mic up? Masavia?
Okay.
Okay. Is Florentine's girlfriend here? Our next act, DC Benny. I tell you the truth, I was up the other night for like 2 hours trying to think of something to write about DC, and then I realized he's really not that interesting. A big hand for DC Benny.
Good to be here and catch a flailing hack. It's another Steinberg big money gig. Estee's here. Estee? Hi, Hitler. Oh, shit, that's funny. I know I'm going to get a call tomorrow. DC, can you do for me? Never again. Please call me to confirm. Look at this dais. What a fucking mook fest. Look at that shit, man. It's like a wine tasting at Mike Buschetti's. It's like the band from Star Wars with no instruments. Okay, let's skip to that. Okay. Boss, last comic stumbling. Oh, man. No, I'm sorry. It's a nice suit. You look like Count Hakula. Boss is happy. No, you're happy. You booked the teeth over today. That was good. Like, I don't give a shit who wins on that show. The best part is Boss actually gnaws his way to freedom from the house. So that's good, you know. Norton's here. His head looks like Lisa Lampanelli's clit. It's the only face to come with a circumcised neck. You talking fucking suppository. Sit around with Manny, act pro-Israel, and then go home and jerk off to Mein Kampf. Patrice, you fucking sociopath. You're a train wreck on the Underground Railroad. When did your comedy become smart? I see you doing pussy fart jokes in the cellar. Okay, next day you're on Tough Crowd talking about your grassy knoll theory, you know? With your fucking cherry loafers. You look like G. Gordon Liddy's golf caddy. Like a 1930s comedy team, aimless and anchovy. You know, step and fetch it, you're fetching, fuck it. That's fucking funny. That's funny. More fun. All right, the poem's coming there. All right, there. Fucking shut up. Fucking Andrew Dice nothing. Shit. Todd Barry's here. Todd Barry, good friend. Last time I saw a head that big, it was being dragged through the streets of Baghdad, beaten with slippers. After this, Todd Barry's going to do a show at Luna. It's going to be an ironic bake sale. Yeah, everybody, eat my brownies. Oh, yeah. Luna Lounge. You know why they call it Luna Lounge? Because once a blue moon, somebody fucking funny works there. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Jeff Singer. Carrie Caravis. I don't know if she's here. Carrie Caravis. Actually, Caravis in Greek means camel toe. She has a perfect body, though. Her body is perfect. There's one small birth defect. No mute button. She sounds like Carrie Hoffman being strangled doing Frank Sinatra. Oh, that's fucking funny. Fags. Oh, fags. The booker from stand-up? What, the Knicks here? Yeah. I thought Chevy Chase had no friends, but Jesus. Nick was going to wear a suit, but he opted for an apple with a parsley garnish. Apple in the mouth. I forgot that. Sue Costello. The funniest thing to come out of her mouth is Chris Mazzilli's dick. I said that before. Mazzilli in Italian means meal ticket. That's mean. That's brutal. I know you're going to get me. I know you're going to get me. I don't give a fuck. Where's Greg Giroffalo is here. Tough Crowd's teacher's pet. He's... That's good. That's good. He's Spanish light. He's Puerto Rican. He makes Andrew Kennedy look like Felix Trinidad. I can't read my fucking writing. Greg actually invented this. I don't know if you know. You guys know that. That's brutal. Yeah. No, Greg is actually Colombian. Hopefully the FARC rebels will come here from Bogota, take his fucking Civil War joke that he closes with, take it back there and fucking bury it. All right. That's too much. Vanessa Hollingshead hired Ross Bennett to write her roast material, which is good because it gave D.F. Sweetler a break from writing the rest of her act. Ross took the time out of her. Ross took the time out of his mystery novel, The Career That Never Was. It's brutal. It's brutal. I don't give a fuck. Boston's actually opening a gift shop. In it, you will have the Ben Bailey action figure, which with an eyebrow that comes in three amazing positions. You can also get the Tony Woods Daylight Savings Time Narcoleptic Alarm Clock. There's no alarm, just a little voice going, "My fault, shorty." And it wakes you up in time to dodge your child support payments. It's great. Oh, now I love Tony Woods. God, I love Tony Woods. Oh, fuck all of you. Nice will to take a break from carrying talent's jockstrap. Meanwhile, across town, Rob Stapleton is doing his cover version of Tracy Morgan's corn kernel in my shit joke. That's fucking funny. This crowd is very discerning. Colin Quinn, host of Tough Crowd, which has been touted as this year's Seinfeld because it's also a show about nothing. He has an entire career based on a blue-collar accent, manufactured outrage, a couple affected tics, and Eddie F's haircut. Alternate names for the show, M. Night Shyamalan's Unwatchable, Weekend Up Chuck, Manny in the Middle, Hot Air Little Dicks and Uncle Tom's. Everyone is using subway fare cards, which is good because now... I fucked that up. Everyone's using subway fare cards, which makes Keith Robinson the only token still working. I made some enemies tonight. Old Kevin Brennan. Kevin Brennan's personality should have a chalk outline surrounding it. And last, I guess this is last. This morning at breakfast, I opened a box of Lucky Charms. Billy Burr jumped out. Billy Burr, also known as Carrot Flop. I think that's it, man. You guys have been great.
DC Benny, how fun. Jesus. What's that? I don't fucking run this. DC Benny, very funny. Jesus. Just burned the only last bridge he had in this business, the fucking cellar. Fuck, where is Nick? Nick's not here? The guy that runs stand-up? He is fucking gay. He sweats cum. What's that? All right, our next act coming to the stage. Let's have a big hand for Vanessa Hollingshead. Vanessa Hollingshead.
Everybody, good to be here. Where's Voss? Where are you going? What, the chick's up and now you can have a cigarette? That's what happens when you've been in the business for a while. Thank you, Rich. I just want you to know every time Rich smiles, he always teaches me a lesson to never buy your teeth over the internet. I'm really moved by tonight's gathering. It wasn't too long ago that in order to get this many white people to show up for an evening featuring a black man, it either involved tap dancing or lynching. help me out, but he did lack some wit. I love you guys. I usually feel bad when a man doesn't want to have sex with me, but tonight I would feel lucky. I have to admit, I'm a little uncomfortable doing this. Patrice and I don't know each other that well. But then again, why would we? I'm not a prostitute. I'll never forget the first time I saw Patrice. I had the same thought most women have. If he dies, I could use his coat to reupholster my sofa. It's good to see Jim Norton tonight. You know, Jim, for a guy who likes women to shit in his mouth, your breath is surprisingly fresh. Jim Norton, a man who has all the sex appeal of a genital wart. Obviously, you've been with him. Keith Robinson, are you here?
Yeah.
Keith? Okay, you are so talented and you've been at comedy so long, but don't worry, your opportunity will come. It will be given to someone else, but it will come. I see we have Jason Steinberg. Hi, Jason. Jason just renamed his company the Colored Agency. Now he's handling black comics, rap artists, and bathroom attendants. Mama. Uh-huh. Can I get a witness in this motherfucker?
Hallelujah.
Hi, Colin. Colin, I'm fucking talking to you. Is proof that all cable networks are not obsessed with things like rating and prestige. It was great being on your show, although to thank you for being on Tough Crowd is like thanking a rapist for pulling out. By the way, Rich, thank you. You know, you guys are very much like the Rat Pack. Colin's like Sinatra, Voss is like Dean Martin, Norton is like Joey Bishop, and Patrice is like Sinatra's valet, George. You know, not many people know that Patrice started doing comedy, when he started acting, he started doing small bit parts. His first job was playing a mole on Della Reese's Snatch. Patrice O'Neill, a man who answers a question with, what would Fat Albert have been like if he were a rude, bitter, disturbing fuck? Oh. Patrice O'Neill, a man whose only aerobic exercise is when he attempts to wipe his own ass.
She was such a fucking bitch, man.
It's always the quiet ones. the truth is, Patrice and I never really spoke until after Lucia and I got separated. And he was very charming and supportive. Yeah, he would say things like, oh, baby, I can tear your ass up. We can have so much fun. For the record, I'd rather have Todd Lynn hit me in the cunt with a baseball bat. Patrice, I can see why you think there'd be a spark between us, because, come on, you and Lucian have so much in common. You know, the only difference between you and Lucian is that Lucian can see his own dick. What, are you going to show me? To say. By the way, Lisa Lampanelli wanted to be here tonight, but she said she was going to be fucking another black guy. Patrice, how does it feel to know that there are only two black guys in New York City Lisa hasn't fucked? And you're both of them.
Vanessa Holling says. Oh, Vanessa. Vanessa. Jesus. She is fucking mean. Jesus. Fucking Vanessa. See, Vanessa, you don't have to marry a club owner here to get stage time. Unless you're Suzanne. Well, shut up. That was fucking... She's a mean person. Well, I guess divorce can make a person bitter, huh? What? Hey, where's fucking Dummy? Where's Keith at?
That fucking idiot ain't coming. He ain't coming.
Keith isn't coming?
Watch, he'll come in running.
Oh, yeah, like he's like the fucking star attraction. Jim Davis here. How you doing? What comedy club will you be spitting at this weekend? Just turn on the fucking weather channel to see. Who the fuck? Keith's not here?
Nope.
All right. Look at all these brothers here looking at this shit. All right, who are we going to bring up next, Dan, if Keith's not fucking here? Oh, shit. It's my pleasure. It's my pleasure bringing up our next act. Let me tell you something. No, Colin. Where's Colin? You know, Colin's the only person that sounds better on a cell phone. All right. Hey, listen, I fucking killed up front. I did my fucking job. A big hand for Colin Quinn.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much. It's great to be here. Rich Voss, who I've known when none of you guys were even in the business, I knew Rich by his old nickname, White Maurice. He, how can I describe Rich? Dane Cook without the artistic integrity. I figured that wouldn't be too funny at Boston, because half you motherfuckers think he's a genius. Now listen, Jesus Christ, there's more wash-ups here than Lacey Peterson and her baby on the... Oh, Jesus Christ. Please, calm down. Even though you guys hated that joke and thought it was in bad taste, Norton thought it was, like, really hip and Lenny Bruce. But Voss is, it's funny watching Voss with all his good friends. I've watched, like, six generations of this with Voss. And, But now... Does it bother you to catch fire after 25 years of comedy? It's really kind of anticlimactic at this point, don't you think? Oh, I hope you get that sitcom deal once. But I'll tell you, though, he's got a lot of different friends, but he's been loyal to his act this whole time. And a lot of people changed. He never changed. Jim Norton. Jim Norton is. He's actually become quite a. He's a comic. He's a headliner too. He can do an hour, if you count 15 minutes, of telling dummies with mullets that their First Amendment rights are being violated because he can't make a Christopher Reeve joke on Letterman. Sure, the forefathers would be proud of that. But let's get to Patrice. Patrice, I can barely see. It's really sad. I'm old. I know that I'm really too old and too big to be at this thing. I understand that. The only reason I came is because Patrice, really, it was so pathetic. His friend came up to me and was like, look, please show up. And I knew I'd be the only semi-name here. Anyway, I know, right now, Norton's going, I'm kind of a name. Well, that was last year. All right, anyway. The heat is off. Let me just talk to Patrice. Let me talk about the man that I really am an old man. Look at this. I can barely fucking see. Well, okay, I'll start with some advice, because he's actually headlining, probably... You know, because a headliner has to leave the audience with that feeling in their stomach. And let me just give you a little advice. Walking a room is not crowd work. Threatening to rape a white girl in front of her parents is not a closing bit. Now... Wearing a sterling silver microphone around your neck, if it was given to you by somebody...
White gold, sorry.
Oh. I can see your priorities are in order for your people. Oh, you really are unbelievable. You're right, we really do stereotype you. Anyway, white gold. I'm a smarmy ass, it's true. Oh, I'm sorry, buddy. Wearing a white gold microphone around your neck is, it's kind of pathetic if somebody gives it to you like an award or something, but when you buy it for yourself, it's almost not to be made fun of. It's so embarrassing. That's true. It is better than Nick's comedy tragedy tattoo. You're right. But, I'm sorry. It's, you know, it's kind of hard. It's the kind of thing that you're embarrassed to even make fun of. Like when Adam Ferrara does a bit to you while you're off stage. But it's good to be here at Boston Comedy Club. This is the funniest. This has the funniest halfway house residence I've ever been to. This club's important because you know what? The comics at Dangerfields have to have some place to look down on. There's my man Billy Burr. He's gone through quite a career change writing wise. No, in the past year he's gone through a metamorphosis. He took the Y off his name, so it's Bill Burr. Good luck with that. Anyway. You actually removed a letter and you still wrote more than Voss last year, so. Oh, God. I'm sorry. And let me tell you something. I fucking love today's man, too. So good for you with that suit. Yesterday's man. What was I going to say? Patrice is, you know, as we all know, he's also a... He's a very, what do you do? He's a hard worker. He wakes up every day
and then calls up everybody he knows until he finds the one kind of new friend that'll call him a genius and talks to him for 3 hours. You know, the thing is, Patrice is like a true, he truly is a brilliant comic because he can never hear the laughter and he can never see the light. And, but I love your spontaneousness on stage is what I really love. No, really. He has new material every night. By new material, I mean he laughs at different places in his same jokes. As if he's heard them for the first time. I was going to make fun of Steve Burns, by the way, but after that fucking skewering the film, I honestly think we should have some kind of vote and just really, nobody should ever let Steve work anywhere again. And he should move back to, oh, fucking, no, I would have said this before the film, actually. He's half Irish, he's the only Asian comic in the country, and he still needs another hook to be funny. Shut up. Shut up. Patrice, I like the fact that you, well, first of all, what's more charming? Because we all know Patrice has a certain charm. That when you don't know Patrice that well, and he gives you that look where he's pretending to appreciate what you're saying to him, but really he's just, you know, he's just recording it for further abuse to tell everybody what an asshole you are. Okay. What was I going to say? Well, I'll say one thing about Patrice. I think the number on his shirt says it all tonight. More of a verb, really, than a number. Thank you. Thank you. You showed it to everybody, and it still barely got a laugh. Jesus Christ, this could be a nightmare for me trying to get off. Hold on. I don't think it's something. You know what? This actually is a very sentimental night for me because this is what comedy was. So I was in the golden era of comedy and, you know, Voss was an MC just like he is tonight. So I'll leave on that. It's close enough. Thank you very much.
Colin Quinn, folks. Colin Quinn. Very funny. You guys got to try Colin's new diet. The only thing you swallow are your words. You know what? This roast has been going for almost 50 minutes, and we haven't heard how much money Todd Lynn has. What are the odds of that? His new sitcom, Come Closer So I Could Shake Your Hand.
Oh, shit.
What? Shut up. Leave him alone. You still got it. Don't worry. Anyway. All right, you know what? Fucking Keith really thinks he's a star.
He's not home.
That fucking creep. I know. He's home stealing fucking videos and that fucking douchebag. All right. Our next act coming to the stage. You might recognize him if you're a guy because I'm sure he fucking blocked you when you're trying to get laid. Todd Barry. A big hand.
Thank you, Rich. We haven't, you're right, we haven't heard how much money Todd Lynn's making. We also haven't had an update from you on how long it's been since you've had a drink or a drug. Unfunny by the grace of God. I'll tell you, people, when I walked in here tonight, I saw not one, but two pizzas. Sliced into half slices. To give the illusion that it was more food than it was. I knew I was involved in some sort of Jason Steinberg shithole event. And I know, Jason, you're saving the third pizza for the after party. It's Misavia? Okay. Thanks for ruining the whole premise of what I'm doing. But it is nice to be here at the newly refurbished Boston Comedy Club. Some people call this place the Boston Comedy Club. Some people call it just the Boston. Some people call it New York Comedy Club with better fire exits. But mainly it's known as the worst club in the city. You're saying, what happened to all those posters, huh? The Rocket Man, the Tommy Boy? Well, rest assured, people, they have been donated to a museum of the shittiest movies ever made. And yes, I did that joke at the Barry Katz roast, but I don't give a fuck. But we're here to talk about Patrice, people, and there's been some similar themes tonight. Patrice is annoying. Patrice is fat. Well, you're not going to believe this. There was a time when Patrice was just fat. When Patrice moved here, he was actually, you're not a fucking quiet guy. I swear to God. And I tried to figure out what happened. I think the big turning point was when he got booked in Amsterdam and a Dutch hooker confused him for an American football star and waved her no black guys rule. But I think fat jokes, it's kind of, you know, it's kind of a cheap shot and it's not fair because I have been with Patrice eating at the Olive Tree. And he's on a very strict diet, people. It involves no alcohol, no dessert, and of course, no tipping. But it's been a great year for Patrice. It has. It really has. Colin Quinn made him a regular panelist on Tough Crowd. And if you think that's an honor, you should keep in mind that Colin is also the guy who thought Keith Robinson should have a writing job. I thought this was a roast, people. Keith didn't even fucking show up, man. But Tough Crowd is actually, it's a great show. I actually know people who work at Comedy Central, and Colin had a great pitch for the show. He said, you know that show, Politically Incorrect? Yeah, I want to do that. And actually, I understand Colin's thinking in hiring Patrice. I mean, think about it. He's thinking, I got this show where I have a group of people having an intelligent discussion about current events. Why not hire a dumb guy who doesn't let people talk? But Patrice is actually, he's quite good on this show, man, and he's very, very versatile. I mean, whether he's insulting Greg Giraldo's shirt during a discussion of capital punishment. Or making fun of the shape of Jim Norton's head in a debate over abortion rights. It's clear Patrice is a man who's never read a paper. But there are a lot of no-shows here tonight. Where is Sherrod Small supposed to be here? I don't know if you guys... If you guys don't know who Sherrod Small is, let me sum it up this way. If you want to see Chris Rock's cousin do Chris Rock's act, you you might want to check out Sherrod Small. And Tony Rock is not here because he's out on the second month of his headlining Way Before He's Ready tour. Anyway, the two pizzas, Tony Rock. You shit on your own manager saying he commissions callbacks. I was just wondering, when have you ever gotten a callback? How would you possibly know that? Oh, I know, the Jay Moore thing. But Patrice is lucky that he's funny. He is funny. Otherwise, he'd end up just like any other small-town bully, mysteriously murdered in broad daylight. Sure, everyone saw Greg Rogel at the car wash scrubbing blood stains from his Toyota. But nobody says anything. I also noticed when Robert Kelly was up here for like an hour, and that didn't bother me, but I saw you sweating because you just realized how many one-nighters in Maplewood, New Jersey you can do in that time. I was going to end tonight by telling Patrice that he's as funny as he is annoying. But then I realized that would make him the funniest man in the history of comedy. So Patrice, I will say you're almost as funny as you are annoying, which still puts you in the top 10. If that came out as a nice thing, then I fucked it up. Thanks a lot, guys.
Todd Barry, folks. Fucking Todd. People are really vicious here. These are not nice people. They're not nice people. Norton's coming up. You know, when Norton's on Colin's show, it should be called Hard to Watch. Norton's the only guy before he tapes the show, he gets makeup and airbrushed. Shut up. Last year, Norton was making tons of money. He sold out Town Hall. This year, for money, he's blowing Rich Hall. We thought that was funny on the phone. Didn't you think that was funny on the phone?
It's funny, yeah.
It is very funny. Is everybody going to take a piss break?
Huh? The tank is full, Rich.
What's that?
The tank is full.
All right, and so is your mouth in a few. Let's have a big...
Richie.
What's that?
Bring it on.
Oh, Jesus, you do one fucking NBC show and they're all over you. Remember that, Colin? Anyhow. A big hand for Jim Norton.
Thank you, everybody. How about a hand for your host, the terrible Jew with John Turturro hair? And as far as NBC, I saw Last Comic Standing. Don't cancel that big weekend in Lancaster yet. You're perfect for television if they're looking for a retarded Jew or a clever Dominican. You stink. Fucking Steinberg brothers, could you have picked bigger idiots to manage your career? You two dumbbells couldn't get De Niro an audition in Tribeca. And I don't want to say that Evan's an alcoholic, but Geraldo actually told him he should go to an AA meeting. Your liver sees more booze than Vanessa's act. The hair looks good, Vanessa. I loved you in Pulp Fiction. I'm glad Todd showed up to retrieve the bat he lost in your cunt. Where is Tony Rock? I know he was mentioned here, or as he's more commonly known, the Black Eric Douglas. I haven't seen somebody get that much mileage out of a brother since, fuck, I forgot the name, Gallagher 2. I suck. God damn me. You really are the worst comic east of Mississippi. You know, you might do better in the business if you didn't sound like Benicio del Toro after a stroke. Fucking first white guy to do Def Jam, which blazed such marvelous careers for people doing the black circuit like Billy Burr, who's, oof. A redheaded guy on BET, you couldn't be more of a novelty act if you put on a hood and juggled burning crosses. Seen Billy perform, picture Carrot Top with shorter hair and shittier material. That fucking high energy dribble, you make Dane Cook look like Woody Allen. Joe Matarese is not here tonight, but he's starring in his own show. It's called Lips Like a Burn Victim. When Joe Matarese lies on his side, his mouth looks like a third grader's cunt. And Bob Kelly, for someone, I cannot believe how stupid you are, considering you spend more time in colleges than the average neurosurgeon. I was just going to say, nobody's like Bob who?
All the work if he got off McDougal Street.
Thanks for helping, stupid.
Sorry!
Might have helped if you weren't dressed like a fat third grader. By the way, congratulations on getting the lead in the Mabel King story. Fucking fat bridge-burning creep. Nobody likes you. If it weren't for fat jokes and pussy farts, you'd be a mime. I do mean it. You did a Showtime special. I don't want to say it was bad, but it was nominated for Best Drama. The only good review you ever got was written by Jason Blair. I don't care if they laugh. That was clever, and I'm happy I did it. Fuck you, retards. Sorry, I'm not making a camel noise like Godfrey. Godfrey has an amazing smile. The only thing whiter than his teeth are the girls he fucks. No offense, Artie. Glad you made it. You look like Godfrey with AIDS. Is it weird for you to be in a club before 1:30 in the morning? It's kind of odd to see somebody not walking by with a broom in the middle of the show. And DC Benny, I've seen you on stage. Your act has more hack characters than a Taxi episode. Like that one? Thank you. I really wish that fucking Robinson was here. Where is that piece of shit? Oh, you know he's not writing. Hey, where's Corey Kahaney besides not using conditioner and that awful dry hair of hers? Corey, where are you? Oh, when you lie on a pillow, does it just snap off like spaghetti? I heard Jim
David and Rick Crome are doing a new show on NBC, Last Comic Kneeling. Keith, I wish he was here, that awful comic. He's hosting a new Survivor. They get a bunch of people into a room to watch his act, and the winner is the only one that doesn't kill himself. And he is also the worst dressed comic. You're not supposed to watch Sesame Street for fashion tips. Although as dumb as he is, he should watch it for educational purposes. It might have been funny if I said educational instead of educational. Whatever you have rubs off, stupid. Keith, he's singing. Can someone tell him you don't have to act out every word of your misery? I was walking. Yeah. We get it, stupid. We speak the same language. That fucking hack does his act in Braille. All right, well, you know, what else can I say, man? Thanks a lot, Patrice. I love you, man. That's it. Thank you.
Jim Norton. Jim Norton. And folks, if you can't fall asleep at night, just close your eyes and count the liver spots on his head. Fucking Jim. You seem really angry Keith isn't here. Fucking Keith. You know, at one time, Keith was fucking Joe Rapp's biggest act.
Why does that...
Who, Joe Rapp? Yeah, he books like the Catskills. You'll find him. You'll find out soon. Who is that? Jesus. Lori, you got to start giving up some pussy to somebody. I'm serious.
Oh, yeah.
Doesn't she? She's hanging around with all these fucking big acts like us, dressing like that. She's fucking somebody. All right, and do it quick, because it might have to be Norton. Fucking so many hookers. Hookers go to Norton's house so much, they use it as a mailing address. This fucker did better for Brazil's economy than heroin. All right, our next act, Billy... who's our next act? Billy Burr. Fucking... Oh, no, wait. Huh? No, it's the fucking lineup right here. It's not by who's sitting where. Haven't you noticed?
Put them on, man. I'm ready.
Who? Gray's ready?
Yeah.
All right. Well, hold on. Jesus Christ. You don't want to piss off Greg. You might get in a fight. Look at him. Holy shit. All right, Greg's ready. You know, Greg's been doing well in this business. He's had a lot of sitcoms. His last one, though, was canceled during a table read. Fucking Greg. He almost had a fight with Greg Rigel, a fucking spick and a dick. Greg Giraldo, a big hand for Greg Giraldo.
Going for unfunny side. You know, honestly, that you definitely won the thing, the house. You definitely won. You are so fucking cocky since you came back from that. You're walking around like you're 5'7" ever since the thing ended. You are a cocky motherfucker. And that show was a fucking disgrace. I swear to God, I wanted to be good spirited about it, but I can't. That show was a fucking humiliation, boss. That show is done. Everyone fucking begging and clawing for public acceptance, desperate and pathetic. It's done worse things for comedians' public image than Modi's USO tour. It was fucking. It was bad. But you are an inspiration, boss. Seriously, you really are. You prove that even with diction like a fucking mallard and bowling pin for teeth, if you stay positive and work hard, after 20 years, you can beat out 6 open micers for a spot on the most degrading show in the history of television. I get all half-finished jokes. By the way, I love this lectern. Can you all see the picture on the front of this lectern? They stole it from a memorial service for a fat Crip that was shot in a drive-by in Brownsville. I'm shocked at how mean people are being, Patrice. I thought I didn't like you. I mean, you know, you honestly, I've said this, I've always said this. You are an incredibly funny coon. I've always said that. Seriously. I can't believe the hostility that people... This is good. This is fun. It's really good to be here. What's that? Sorry about the crip thing. What happened? what are you pointing at? Well, this is good. Who else do we need to discuss? I have a lot of half-finished fucking ideas up here. Bobby Kelly. It was good to see Bobby Kelly here with his whole fucking audio-visual presentation. He's used to carrying a lot of shit all at Dane Cook's golf club, so he's used to carrying a lot of shit. Dane Cook himself couldn't be here because he was home. Dane Cook was home remembering all kinds of hilarious shit that happened when we were kids. We couldn't really make it out. Norton, good to see Norton. How do you insult the guy who hires hookers to piss in his face? You know what I mean? What do you say? His chin has seen more noxious fluids than Lisa Lampanelli's panty shield. I'm just saying it's true. Colin Quinn, who you know, honestly, and I'm not just saying this because my contract's almost up and I can already see the handwriting on the wall for how this is going to play out, is one of the funniest, fucking most insightful guys I've ever met. But he got so much fucking hate mail to begin. I couldn't believe it. People just hated him. They sent all kinds of hostile, horrible shit, and I didn't agree with any of it except for the stuff about him being gay.
Shit was that motherfucker. Say something to me, bitch.
I'm just calling him gay. That's not me.
You told him he was wonderful, you fucking cocksucker. Roast him.
I'm about to. But honestly, I do. I thought calling him gay is pretty mean. No, I know to you it's not a big deal, but to most people, sucking a cock matters. The whole thing is. Colin's got this weird. I never noticed how fucking gay-like he was. I really didn't. I never noticed. And then all of a sudden you read, like, he's got those gay hand mannerisms. And it's true. When he picks something up at the table, he looks like fucking Mario Cantone at origami class. But he's getting married. He's getting married soon. Colin Quinn is getting married. How about a hand for Colin? Those are Colin Quinn is getting married. Those are five words I never thought I'd hear. Sort of like Comedy Central presents Keith Robinson. That shit was funny, dude. Now what else? We got Todd Lynn is here, of course. He's always complaining about the man keeping him down. We have a lot of arguments about that. Todd thinks it's all racism keeping him down. Todd, you've had fucking, how many deals have you had already? Have you watched yourself? You're about as fucking interesting as fucking rectal herpes, for Christ's sake. And how many deals have you had? Holy shit, saying you need more breaks is like saying Bill Burr needs more forehead. I thought that was, no? Was that too mean? Because then I better not do the other one. Then I can't do the other one if that was too mean.
Is it?
All right. Let's just get to Patrice. How about that? The manatee of the hour. It's fucked up. I think I like you more than most people. I really got no problem with Patrice. And I'm actually sort of envious of his lifestyle. Like, I wish I could just travel all over the world, leaving a trail of flattened hookers in my wake. He's always trying to make me feel shitty about my own life, about being married with kids. I'm like, yeah, I wish I didn't have that. I wish I can get on a plane for 14 hours with three greasy comics and two giant creepy Jews, you know, to go fuck some syphilitic slum dweller who's got to struggle as hard as she can not to have a disgusted look on her face as she wipes your milky load off her chin. You know, you can see her just thinking, don't throw up, don't throw up, don't throw up, don't throw up. The four kids will eat tonight. Just don't fucking puke. Specifically, I mean that whole crew of fucking mongrels, these fucking boss over there in Rio acting like a playa, taking his $200 from the VFW weekend gig and like, ooh, baby. By the way, how fucking annoying is it with that little hook you got now? Like, I'm too big, folks, I'm too big for this. I'm too big for this. I'm a headliner. I'm a fucking headliner. You never finish a sentence, which is at the ground round this Friday night at the big comedy.
I'm not haggling. I honestly have no idea if this has been too much or too little. Has it been too much? I really can't tell if this is going to be a fucking disaster. There was the other one I wanted to do that we talked about before, but I think, no. No. Let's just get back. Let's just get back to Patrice for one split second. I do I do respect you, Patrice. I think you're a funny, funny guy. I think you're a truth teller. But you know what? I'm getting a little tired of defending you. Seriously, everywhere I go, people come up to you like, "Hey, who is that stupid, fucking, ignorant, uninformed, fat motherfucker on Tough Crowd? Who's that big, fucking, gorilla, dumbass that never read a paper that knows fucking nothing in the world? Who's that stupid motherfucker, that big, fat cunt sitting next to you?" This is people, Patrice. I'm telling you, they're fucking mean people. "Who is that uninformed, stupid, motherfucking, worthless bag of shit?" And I always stand up for you. I defend you all the time. I tell him, "You gotta remember, the camera adds 10 pounds. Thank you very much, everyone.
Fucking great show, bravo. That was fucking funny. See, Norton could be followed in a roast. Greg Giraldo. There's too much heat for Norton. Fucking Eddie Hiff's in the room now. How you doing, man? Fucking Jack Ruby has a better television career than you. The fucking horse's head in The Godfather 2 did better in the business. Godfather 1, 2, shut the fuck up. 1 or 2 gives a fuck. They got the fucking joke, okay? Fucking Norton doesn't take shit from anybody unless it lands on his chest. No one's calling you. Fucking Keith. What a fucking zero he is. More comics have passed Keith Robinson in this business than the last place runner in the New York Marathon. Okay. Why does everybody groan when you do a Keith Robinson joke? They like Keith? Oh, fuck him. Sell out. Fuck Keith. They love him. Okay. Our next act coming to the stage, I guess you would call him Kathy Griffin without tits, Billy Burr.
All right, thank you. Keep it going for Rich Voss, everybody. Come on, everybody. And for those of you who saw Last Comic Standing, how about a round of applause for the official end of his fucking career? Come on, everybody. Rich, that was the worst fucking show I've ever seen in my life. I can't believe you said yes to that. Fucking Al LaBelle turned down that show. Jesus, it's fucking unbelievable. He's been in this business 39 years. He's competing with open micers. You didn't even fucking stand out. You should have looked like Christ. You didn't look like Christ. You didn't even look like a comedian. You look like a fucking landscaper who's just trying the shit out on a whim. But you're dumb. You deserve it. Look at Rich. Rich spent $3,000 on a watch and $8 on his teeth. Look at him. He looks like fucking John Elway. He's a football player from 20 years. These can't all be gems, people. There's a decent line, right? Maybe if you didn't spit on somebody every 20 seconds, you get a fucking deal, man. Look at that thing. That's not a bridge. It's a fucking dam. Something. All right, let's move on, because that's dying. All right, Vanessa Hollingshead is here, everybody. Vanessa, I've seen you for like the last 7 years. I got one question asked about your act. What the fuck are you talking about? No one cares about your stupid characters. Just talk about your dick and get off the stage. Too mean, it's a roast. Fuck all of you. It's all right, thank you. It's getting worse, people. I'm starting off with the cute ones. All right, I just got back from the Mike Birbiglia's one-man show called An Evening with Todd Barry. Thank you. Todd Barry, little advice, maybe if you brought the energy up just a little bit, you could get a food spot at the Cellar. Oh, and speaking of the Cellar, Manny and Esty just wrote a book called How Dare You Work Another Club. Keith Robinson wrote the foreword. I'm going to read some of it. "No matter, I won't be working no other club." Bring it up, Modi, boss. Bring it up, Modi. his soul for free nachos and buffalo wings. Just fucking around. I tease the Comedy Cellar. I love the Comedy Cellar. You know what I love about the Comedy Cellar? I love the wide variety of acts that they have on their weekends. On Saturday, we have four wonderful shows. At 7 o'clock, we have Tom Papa, Greg Giraldo, Nick DiPaolo, and Colin Quinn. At 9 o'clock, we have Nick DiPaolo, Colin Quinn, Greg Giraldo, and Tom Papa. At 11 o'clock, we have Nick DiPaolo, Colin Giraldo, fucking Who Gives a Fuck, and Alan Havey. Let me ask you a question. I got one question. Who the fuck is Alan Havey? Every 6 weeks I get that. I'd love to give you more spots, but Alan Havey is in town. Oh, well, shit, let's clear the fucking schedule. Alan Havey is in town. Jesus Christ, by any chance did he bring Mark Cohen with him? It's a roast, man. I'm letting it go. You like it? Beautiful, beautiful. All right, fuck all of you, because this is still, we're at the halfway point. All right, I worked with the Sklar brothers recently. I got one question for the Sklar brothers. Do they both have to be up there? Is there any reason for both of them? Can't one of them just recite that awful material? Awful. And God, they're ugly. They're the answer to the question, what would happen if Jeff Ross fucked Mel Brooks? I was talking about the Sklar brothers. All right, Tom Papa, I don't know if he's here. Tom Papa has a new show coming out this fall. Evidently, it takes place inside of Jerry Seinfeld's ass. Orny Adams lives in the prostate, and it's called Who Are These People Up My Ass? What, are you guys all getting a fucking guest star on it, you fucking sellouts? Don't make fun of him. He has a deal. Where do you go from here? A couple more bridges. Colin Quinn is still here. God bless him. Colin, come on, round of applause for the one celebrity who showed up here tonight. God bless him. Colin, I just have one question for you. Why are you still fucking here? You're at least twice as old as anybody here. No one cares about your take on the war in Iraq. And even if we did, we couldn't understand what the fuck you're saying. You fucking mush-mouth hack. If you're gonna keep doing spots, at least take a fucking speech class. Somebody, you got your own show. Why are you still here? What do you think? You, that tough crowd's like a stepping stone? You're 58 years old. This is it for you. It's not going any higher. Go on the road like Gallagher 2, except instead of smashing the watermelons, he's going to eat them. Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, which brings me to this tub of shit. Patrice O'Neill. What I've loved about him is he's fat and arrogant. It's the oddest combination I've ever seen in my life. Like, he refuses to do Comic View. He actually feels that he's above it. I will not do Comic View. Patrice, your whole act is perfect for that show. You do 11 minutes, you pretend to talk about Russia, and then you do 52 minutes of pussy jokes. And you won't do Comic View? I mean, Patrice, you're so comic. You got a deal for your own TV show. You blew all your money on a pinky ring, a used Cadillac, and football jerseys. And you won't do Comic View? Patrice, you are Comic View. Why didn't you at least get your fucking teeth fixed? Patrice, you have the worst teeth in entertainment. None of them match. I worked in a dental office for 5 years. I've never seen anybody with a molar in the front. No business having a headshot. Howard Feller called. He wants his old teeth back. Look at the space between his front teeth. He looks like a fat 50 cent. Poor 50 cent. I'm just fucking with him. I do. I got to do a disclaimer. I'm getting the most fucking groans here. And Patrice is fat. Patrice has that awful fat person bad breath where you don't know if it's coming, the smell's coming from his mouth or one of the folds in his neck. Patrice's breath smells worse than Jim Norton's chest. But I make fun of Patrice. I make fun of Patrice only because I'm jealous of his career. Seriously, he's doing great. He just booked the lead in the sequel to Mighty Joe Young. Patrice, you really do. You really do look like an out-of-shape gorilla. You look like that gorilla at the zoo that doesn't want to fuck anymore. God. I was playing with all of you. God bless all of you. I love you, Patrice. Only for 10 years. Seriously, man. I'd do anything for you. Thank you.
I know. Hey, Billy Burr. Billy. Billy, no, he's not going next. He doesn't just fucking walk in like he's a celebrity and go next. No, let Lingo. No, fuck him. Esty doesn't care if you get back to the club. Calm the fuck down. They're here. Shut up. I can't see you. Fucking a big hand for Billy Burr. What's that? Oh, Billy went up. Look at Billy. Look at Billy. He's shaking. I know. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Manny. I'm sorry, Esty. Sit down. Hey, stupid, sit down. You are done. Just thank God you didn't trash anybody at BBQ's or you wouldn't be working this weekend. Fucking Billy. Look at him. He's so fucking happy. Surprised you came up here without your FUBU clothing. Fucking failed in both fucking... Oh, sorry. I didn't say it. Oh, shit. I saw Johnny Lambert. How you doing, man? When did you get back into comedy? Jesus Christ. Talk about relics. That fucker looks up to D.F. Sweetler. All right, our next act coming to stage. To tell you the truth, I don't know really how funny she is, but she's really a looker. let's have a big hand for Lynn Coppola. Come on.
I'm here tonight for Carrie Caravis because she had to play a club. She had to do casual times in the basement. And, you know, $50 is $50. So she asked me, she wrote the jokes and asked me to please come here and deliver them for you, Patrice, in her words. And all the material you're going to hear right now is in no way. To bet with Carrie. So this is for her, and everything you're going to hear is in no way a reflection of my opinion.
What was the bet that your show would last more than a month?
Patrice, you fat fuck. Patrice went to Brazil and came back bragging about how he had sex with two women at one time. Yeah, it took one to hold up his stomach and one to find his dick. A lot of people don't know this, but Patrice's forte is eating pussy. As you can see, there's nothing he won't eat. Rich Voss is so dumb, he has more Kangol hats than IQ points. Rich Voss hangs out with black comics because he thinks his dick will get bigger and his act will get funnier. Neither one's working. Your teeth just look bigger and whiter, and you're better off hanging out with Rigel. This way your dick will look larger and you won't seem so bitter. Jim Norton is so kinky. He once told me he likes it when women pee on him. I asked, what does that taste like? He said, popcorn. Thanks for ruining the movies for me forever. Nasty bastard. Jim Norton is such a sex addict. One time I caught him in the green room of Tough Crowd fucking the fat rolls on the back of Patrice's neck. Get help, Jim. I would love to say something about Rondell Hartley, but no one knows him. Keith Robinson kills every night. Does it count when you laugh at your own jokes? Stop laughing, stupid. Carrie wrote these. Go fuck yourself. Okay. Keith Robinson laughs so much during his set, the audience thinks they should tell him jokes. It's always fun to see Raquel and Patrice together. They remind me of Jabba the Hutt and that little thing that hops around him. Or Shrek and the donkey. That's not fair. Patrice has never been as charming as Shrek, and Raquel has never been as happy or as funny as that donkey. I don't know if his body is really big. Oh, Todlin. I don't know if his body is really big. Or his head is very small. Or is it the arm throwing the whole fucking thing off? I didn't even notice. This is Carrie, not me. Fucking whore. Todlin thought the roast was for him tonight. He heard they were roasting a big fat black guy. Sorry, Todd, we're roasting the big fat black guy with talent. It's Carrie! Okay. Billy Burr. The only reason Patrice hangs out with Billy Burr is because he thinks it'll increase his chances of getting laid. Let's be honest, no one wants to fuck a redhead. Redhead, shit, I'd fuck Bin Laden before I'd fuck Patrice. Who's Carrie kidding? She'd fuck you, Patrice, as long as you, you know, didn't speak English and treated her badly, okay? That was me. I slipped out. Sorry. Eddie Ift. Eddie is still bitter because Orny Adams beat him out of the part as the obnoxious guy in the movie The Comedian. Eddie was quoted saying, "It's not fair. I'm more self-obsessed than Orny." Lynn Coplitz was so bad on Change of Heart, they brought the guy she replaced back. I didn't read through these. Okay. Sue Costello didn't want to come tonight because she was afraid she'd have to sit next to Patrice and his tits are bigger than hers. Vanessa Holling said every time she breaks up with Lucian, her hair turns another color. Jason Steinberg is here tonight, and he is a great manager, especially when he takes his Ritalin. Rich Voss, Jim Norton, Robert Kelly, Colin Quinn, Patrice O'Neill, the modern day Rat Pack with no talent. More like the Hack Pack. Okay, now go fuck yourself. Okay. Now Carrie has some gifts for Patrice that she wanted me to give him. One is this book called Diabetes Solutions. I'm afraid he's going to have a heart attack walking up into Boston. And then she apparently, I don't know where she found these, but she was able to find some headshots of Patrice from a long time ago that she wanted to show off.
Cobblers for Carrie Kravitz. Fucking Carrie's a prop act and she's not even here. Fucking Carrie sending you fucking presents. Carrie's gonna be in a movie, My Big Fat Greek Mouth. They're getting tired?
Yeah, I think they're getting tired.
Yeah, they're getting tired, but we only got a couple more. I think this is going good. You guys having a good time tonight? All right, let's run it along. Don't fuck with my car. Nobody knows who the fuck you are just strolling in here. Fuck is he? Who is he anyhow? He's on a sitcom? He's on a daytime soap opera? Wow, that's one step above commercials. Daytime sitcom. What, you trying to impress me with that? Fuck, Artie's just getting on stage then. All right. Fucking people, hang in there, folks. We got a couple more. There's going to be an after party in Patrice's stomach. All right. Our next act. What's that? Yeah, he's got to, and then you. Oh, what? What the fuck? I didn't do the fucking lineup. I'm going by the lineup, man.
I'll wait till tomorrow.
What's that? Oh, now Ben's getting mad because he's not next. Bring Ben. Our next act is a good friend of mine. I play golf with him, and he has no anger problems whatsoever. And no, Keith, sit back down. You can still go over to New York Comedy Club and do your spot and then come back. Folks, hang in there. A couple more. Ben Bailey.
Jesus fucking Christ. You know how hard it's been to sit there and not get drunk by now? Sitting there for 4 fucking hours. Keith shows up in a break between bringing on Steve Byrne and Artie at the Cellar, and he's going to fucking get right on. He's hosting right now around the corner. All right, here we are. Patrice O'Neill. Shut the fuck up, Robinson. Fat-headed retard. I'll fucking throw you back over there. Shut up. Shut up. I've been drinking and I'm feeling violent. Patrice O'Neill's roast. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight the world's hungry will feast on roasted filet of hack. Fuck you. Nobody in here even knows your name. Shut up. Patrice, I'd start. I'd like to start by listing a few things that I truly feel sorry for. Your feet, your chair, your belt, your toilet, and your mother's uterus. Now let's get started. You fat, obnoxious prick. You giant waste of human life. You reason for all pain, sorrow, and remorse. You are truly nothing more than a giant shit stain on the filthy underwear that is the comedy business. I would call you pretentious, which is defined as expressing excessive or unwarranted importance, worth, or stature. But I'm pretty sure you wouldn't be able to spell it. So for tonight, let's stick to things like fat and dumb. In England, Patrice is a little girl's name. Here in the U.S., it's a name you give a child that you hate, regardless of sex. Here are a few names I think might be more appropriate. Fat fuck. Fatty fat, fat fat, fat fucker. Hack squatch. Really fat Albert. The Pepsi Cola fat ass. Furious George, feed the children, food spot, and my personal favorite, Grimace. Please do us all a favor. Eat a cake and kill yourself. Jim Norton. It is hard to write an insult about a man whose physical appearance is so insulting in itself. It's hard to hurt a man who has to get up every day and see that face looking back at himself in the mirror, horrified. You look like one of those stress dolls whose ears pop out when you squeeze his head. Except you're uglier and stupider. You've always been one of my favorites, Jim, but don't let it go to your head. I only know 2 other pedophiles. Thank you. tonight. What do you say to a man who's made a name for himself by telling baby rape jokes and paying people to piss and shit on him? You twisted little freak of a man. You look like that pathetic little bird from Bugs Bunny who couldn't catch anything for dinner, except he was cute. You're living proof that even pseudo-celebrity status can make an ugly man seem attractive to a transvestite hooker who is stranded at a truck stop. You look like a giant albino sea turtle that accidentally swam out of his shell and washed up on the beach dead. Who had such a collection of hideously ugly clothing and the awful pear-shaped body to match until I met Keith Robinson. Shut up, whore. Keith, you have the worst sweater collection in history. Sinbad would be appalled at your wardrobe and your act. You have no chance of success, and you know it. That's why the words, God damn it, come out of your mouth at least 100 times in every boring set that you do. You look like an older version of Martin Lawrence if he was out of shape, lonely, and unsuccessful. Unsuccessful. Which is a brand new term. You should have stuck with wrestling. I'm sure the Black Scorpion had a better career path. A better career path than Keith goddammit Robinson ever will. And I know he had a better outfit. You took little Kev under your wing and he ripped it off and flew away with it. Shut up, you showed up just in time. He took little Kevin under your wing, he ripped it off and flew away with it, leaving you with one wing flying in circles between New York and Philadelphia forever. Quit now so that both of your shitty cars can finally have a rest. Rich Voss. All right. Here's
my God.
The first thing I wrote about Voss. Hey, shut up. Shut up.
Shut up, Keith.
It better be just as good as that shit you wrote about me, you asshole.
He likes Voss better.
Or,
so far, I give this roast 3 stars.
You've been sitting on that all night. I really feel sorry for that comment. I'm trapped under that fucking fat ass for 3 hours. Mo, why'd you have to give him a chair with arms on it? You knew he wasn't gonna fit. He's inadvertently gonna carry that all the way to the parking garage. To 4 stars yet, you fat fuck. This first thing about Rich Voss I wrote more than a week ago. That is the ugliest fucking suit I have ever seen. And I saw the one you wore to the last roast. As we speak, you're probably on Last Comic Standing, which I prefer to call Voss's Last Stand. Tell me, did you win or did you get to the final round and have another anxiety asthma attack and get wheeled out while some other open micer collected the prizes in glory? You're a giant retarded midget. If you are the last comic standing, it's only because they thought you were sitting down. You have the body of a mutant 12-year-old, teeth like Tony Robbins, the hands of a circus midget, and your skin looks like it was made from an old saddlebag. The only non-Asian I know who is constantly squinting, and it certainly isn't because of the brightness of your future. super neurotic has-been wannabe. Sell that fake Rolex and buy your children some food and clothes. Trade in that knockoff Mercedes kit car and try not to spend all the cash on trips to the tanning salon. And don't say, no, I don't go to tanning salons. I was headlining in Florida. Everybody knows it's bullshit. Somewhere in the slums of Central Jersey, there's a tanning salon owner with a four-bedroom house that's completely paid for. Between gambling and tanning, you must spend twice your annual income. You are a pathetic fucking idiot, and you look like a jockey who stole his horse's teeth. Talk about Greg Giraldo. Greg Giraldo, tough guy of late, has been going around starting fights with audience members and picking on big bad dudes like Greg Rogel and Dan Natterman. Why didn't you pick on somebody your own size, like Lisa Lampanelli? You are always well prepared on Tough Crowd. A little too well, actually. It's kind of annoying to watch you there in that smarmy I went to Harvard face and those too tight shirts with your beauty school hairdo. If you looked any gayer on the show, Jim David would have two less TV credits. Time to make a choice, Greg. Harvard know-it-all, drunken Mexican street fighter, or Chelsea hairdresser.
Great.
I leave it to you.
Ben, I've never heard you be funny before.
Sit down. That almost got it.
Is there a light?
No, shut up. There's anyone in this room who could never complain about somebody going over, it's you, you fat-headed asshole. Shut the fuck up. I got another half an hour.
Jesus.
Pull another fucking Star Search joke out of your fat hole.
This is 10 years in the making. Go ahead.
That's right. And everybody's going to sit through every fucking rotten minute of it.
Did she help you write this?
Shut up. Myself. I started in 1993.
God
damn! This is like a therapeutic. I don't really live there, dummy. It's a joke. Bobby Kelly.
What did you write on
Bob, shut up!
Application?
You guys are enjoying this too much. What do you think is slowing me down? Bobby Kelly. Bobby, I feel for you, man. I got everybody. My alcohol problem. 40 years ago, when you started doing comedy, you were sucking dick for crack. Shut the fuck up. I'm not leaving until I'm done, so you fuckers Jeez. Better shut up and so we can get done with this shit.
We gotta get something to drink.
Yeah. Like we don't all know you mean eat. You fuckers better let me finish this shit, goddammit. Bobby Kelly, I really feel for you, man. It can't be easy waking up every day knowing that you'll never live up to your website. I'd call you fat and stupid, but that would be like calling the sky blue. It's been said so many times you don't even argue anymore. You just go, yeah, I'm stupid, so what? So you're stupid, that's what, you fat dope. If kryptonuts is the best thing you could come up with, maybe you should move back to Saugus and tell them all how tough it was living here in Manhattan. And while we're at it, you runaway Bob's big boy sign. There is no such thing as a porcupine, papa poo poo cream, a billisecond, or a piss your pants monster. You fucking child, grow up and write something about other than how stupid you are. Fuck, I fucked it up. All right, that's one fucker. Just another minute.
Jesus.
I'm cutting it short as it is. Hey, my biggest fucking... Kevin Brennan. I don't know what it is about Kevin Brennan that makes me hate him so much. Perhaps his bubbly personality or his friendly demeanor. Perhaps it's the way he always says hello to everyone and always has a kind word to say. Or perhaps it's the fact that he has a little brother who is more successful in the comedy business than he is. Let me ask you something, Kevin. When you guys flipped a coin a decade ago to decide who would try to be funny and who would kiss Dave Chappelle's ass, who did you think won the coin toss then? Sherrod Small.
Oh, jeez.
Good evening, sir.
I like you, Ben.
I like you, too.
Everybody else, I'm kicking their ass.
No one in the business has a stronger hand of race cards and relationship aces than Sherrod Small. Even Tony Rock is less likely to pull one out during a dispute with, say, a bartender or a club booker.
Yes!
You two guys are doing awfully well awfully early on. I just have one question for you both. Would you be getting so many spots if you were related to Artie?
I'm in the same room, black girl!
And speaking of hacky come latelys, will somebody tell Kyle Grooms that being a comic in Florida doesn't mean shit here in New York? If you sounded any more like Dave Chappelle, you'd have to change your stage name to Snively McDaniel. Won't it be interesting to watch Kyle build a successful career around Dave's character voice, only to find out in the end that it was all a revenge plot carefully crafted by Tony Woods? This must be... Oh, Todd Berry, here we go. Todd, I've never known anyone whose head looked more like a giant testicle. Too bad you're not a prop comic. I know you'd never use props. It's beneath you. You'd rather maintain your integrity by slowly whispering the audience into a deep, deep sleep. And waiting around nervously to see if any of the waitresses are drunk enough to go home with you. In a word, sir, you are icky. Sue Costello, you used to be known by the sitcom that bore your name. Now you are simply known as Chris Mazzilli's girlfriend. But that's not all bad. Chris is the owner of a very successful restaurant. All right, a very successful comedy club, too. In fact, Chris Manny is here tonight. If you go to the bathroom, I recommend taking your drink with you. And speaking of the Comedy Cellar, it is rumored that Barry Katz has recently threatened the Comedy Cellar by saying, I can hurt the Comedy Cellar. What do you plan to do, Barry? Start managing it?
Keith was trying to slip out that door. Jesus, you were trying to act like Norton looks, a marshmallow. Come on, Keith Robinson.
God damn.
Wow, that's the most stage Tom Bennett's had in 13 years. That motherfucker used that up wisely. He got fucking open micers, everybody in that shit. All right, man, now he made me wish I would have wrote for this shit, now. But I didn't, so fucking take what I got, goddammit. Right off the cuff. If it stinks, it stinks. I don't give a fuck.
If?
Yeah. That may stink. Who knows? All right, let's see what we got. Before we get to the main course, Patrice O'Neill, we're going to go around the room and see what we got here.
You want to go fucking regroup another minute?
I know, after that, after fucking Ben Bailey fucking went out with getting, he's still getting handshake. Look at Artie. Man, can I open for you the next roast? That motherfucker Artie like, yeah, man, that was good, that was good. Ben, can you talk to Esty for me? Talk to Esty.
Look at Ross. Ross Bennett got a booking for him.
Give me that shit, man. Throw that shit to me, baby. Throw that shit. Anyway, let's see what we talk about. Let's see who's here. Todd Lynn is here. What's up, Todd? What can we say about Todd? That he hasn't already emailed you? IM'd you? Or written on a message board himself? Todd was, you know, he was rich. That's what Todd said. He's rich. Todd. Rich.
What?
Does everything a rich person does, too. As soon as he gets some new money, he goes out and buy every fucking thing in the book, goddammit. That's why I said goddammit, because I knew that wasn't going nowhere. Who else is here?
Hold the fuck up. Is this your act four?
Oh! Shut the fuck up, goddammit. I got more, goddammit, I got more. This is right off my head, too, goddammit. So y'all accept it. Oh, and Robert Kelly. How about Robert Kelly? Give it up for Robert Kelly. I'm sure he did good. Robert Kelly is the only guy that can be described as bitter and jolly in the same sentence, goddammit. I thought that would do something. What?
Why don't you try fucking the stool?
You did that, Robert, when you were a handsome Italian, you know. Now that you're a fat Mexican, that shit don't work. Fuck, you know what, folks? This is all I got! I'm gonna step it up in a half a second. God damn, I'm losing the crowd. What the fuck? I never had a walkout on a roast before, but what the fuck?
Thanks for coming to the roast.
All right, wait a minute. Here we go. I think I got something else. Oh. Greg Giraldo's here. Greg Giraldo had one of the funniest half-hour one-night stands of all time. Common Law, I think it was called.
I get it.
Common
I get
Law?
That shit.
No?
I get it. Fuck
nothing.
Y'all.
Fuck, that was
that
good.
That shit was funny, motherfuckers.
Don't stick up for him.
All right. Here's my last thing. If this one don't go,
you do good.
I'm quitting comedy. This is the one joke. If this shit don't go, I actually prepared this one.
I fucking sweat like one of Lisa's lines.
Thank you, boss. I knew you'd save me. I seen last night Comic Standing last night. Forget about that tour you were thinking about, jackass. Fuck, God damn it! All right, here it is, Patrice. I don't have to get off of this, God damn it.
You're doing so bad, you should strap yourself around Hood's waist.
I can take this pound, and I can take it. I'll be leaving comedy for the next 4 weeks, maybe a year. I really should have wrote for this shit. All right, here it is. Okay, here it is. This is the thing. I was over at Norton's house. I was sleeping over, and I happened to come across some letters that Norton had wrote out. And this is why he was on. When he got Opie and Anthony, here's some of the letters that he wrote. Dear Dice, I... Oh, fuck this. You know what, folks? Heckling me. This is bullshit. Wait a minute. I've never been heckled at a fight. I haven't been booed this bad since the Apollo in 1990, goddammit. I should, you're right. Shut up, I got more. I got fucking more, and I'm gonna stay on here until I get it all the fuck out. So, where you from, man? shut the fuck up, Ben.
Or what?
Oh, shit. Ross Bennett, thank you for stopping through. Oh. Is that camera still rolling? I got walkouts. Thank you for coming. I'm gonna stay up here until everybody fucking leaves. What do you think about that?
Hey, Masabia, give her a free ticket. Tell her she.
Hey, fuck it. Ben killed. I fucking, you know.
Oh, Jesus. Now you know how Vanessa felt on Tough Crowd.
No, I don't. All right, what else can I say to fucking destroy this show? Fuck it, night. It's never good night, goddammit. Until the fat lady sings. I set you up for that one. Wait a minute. Hold on, folks.
Do Bruce Lee.
Who?
Do Bruce Lee.
You know, I'm gonna have to do Bruce Lee in a minute. Who said the Sandman? Shut the fuck up, goddammit, if I assure you the Sandman. All right, here we go. That was a mean one. It doesn't have to be funny. Shut the fuck up, like I said before. Now, here. I'm not calling shit a fucking day. If I go down, this whole fucking roast goes down, goddammit.
It's already down.
Hey. Well, folks, I should have took my first voice and went home. Who? Yeah, who's up next? Shut up. Who the fuck up? Shut up. Now you're not. You're going to trash me some more.
He wants to take over MCing. That's all you used to.
All right, here we go, folks. Before I go. They better be able to fight. Before you can play music. Nah, shut the fuck. I don't give a fuck. Big don't mean shit to me. I can throw a little bit. Big don't mean shit to me. I'm going to stay up this bitch into everybody. Turn the lights down. Wave. Oh, I know, right? y'all can sing, dance. I don't give a fuck. I do what I want to do when I want to do. Who? Rhonda. All right, I'm gonna bring to the stage an open micer. Goodbye. La 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 la. La, la. No! I stay on forever. Fuck that! I'm staying forever. This is the end of my spots at the Comedy Cellar, so I'm staying on Boston forever.
Tell me, gotta bring on Artie.
All right. This. I'm doing what the fuck I want to do. And I will never leave the fucking stage. If you don't turn the mic on, I'll never fucking leave. Now you better turn that mic the fuck back on or I won't leave. I will not leave. Get the fuck out of here. Fuck out of here. If you don't turn the mic on, I won't leave.
Turn the mic, Keith Robinson. That was the best kill bomb I've ever seen. Who would think the audience would want Mike Estime to move back into town? Oh, shut up. Who cares who you like? Jesus Christ. Fucking Keith, what are you slipping? One of Norton's jokes? All right, folks. That was as funny as... Keith cannot follow Ben Bailey. Keith can't follow Ben. Keith can't follow Ben. Keith can't follow Ben. Keith can't follow Ben. Hold on, Patrice is coming up. Patrice, folks, are you guys ready for the man of the hour? I know it's going to be tough for him to follow Keith. A big hand for Patrice O'Neill, folks.
Thank you. Turn that up, please. Turn it up, please, Savia. So that was embarrassing for my friend. A lot of people, but you gotta understand, that's what we do. Keith is gonna hear about that every fucking day for a long time. And I understand what he was doing, but it was in front of comics. You can't trick them with your fucking "I'm not gonna bomb" kind of trick. They just. I'm gonna do this, and I don't care if I walk the room. It's comics. They're gonna stand there and fucking laugh at you like they did. So, what are you gonna do? Well, I don't know where to start from. Let's start with Todd Lynn. Everybody been taking pokes at Todd Lynn. Todd Lynn got a $1 million development deal from ABC. Now, $5 more million, he'll be able to afford a bionic arm. That was pretty good. Knock, knock. Greg Giraldo's 13 spots on Conan O'Brien.
Greg Giraldo's 13 spots on Conan O'Brien who?
Exactly. What does Ben Bailey and the Belmont Stakes have in common? Neither one had a funny side. Thank you, that was okay. God bless my friend. Dean Edwards, an archaeological team has been hired to see if they can discover any evidence that Dean was ever on Saturday Night Live. Seen Dean get edited out the ending wave at the Dean... Chris Kattan covered his wave. A lot of people don't know I have diabetes. I'm scared of losing a limb, but it won't be so bad because I know I can still fuck Vanessa Hollingshead. Thank you. That was terrible. Was that too mean? What are you gonna do? That was terrible. Yeah. Yeah, that bitch was fucking that. She was really going at me. God bless you. God bless DC Benny. I heard he's taking over the show when Dave Attell leaves. The new show's gonna be called Now I Can Finally Get Some Sleep. I heard Chris Rock telling Sherrod if he doesn't get funnier, he's gonna only refer to himself as Tony Rock's cousin. Donnell is here at the roast. I'm glad Donnell is here at the roast. Donnell Rollins only came to the roast because it's a word that reminds him of warming up. All that shit about me and y'all fucking, well, what are you gonna do? Lisa Lampanelli only sucks dick so she can do the spit take. Billy Burr does so many black rooms that now he does an impression of Paul Mooney doing an impression of Brian Regan. Paul Mooney doing an impression of Brian Regan. Fucking dick. Red-headed nigger hack. Hey, did you hear the new... It was a news report that... they found a miracle drug that cures all diseases, and on a sad note, Jim Norton just quit comedy. SARS. AIDS. I like to take a nail and on a hand with a. I wish she had a. Monkeypox. A new one. Manny from the cellar just invited me over his house for the first time. I couldn't believe how much furniture you could fit in Seinfeld's asshole. Was there already a Seinfeld asshole joke? Eh, whatever. I can never do as bad as Keith Dipstead. Fuck that. Lisa Lampanelli, when she was a baby, Lisa Lampanelli used to cry like this. Wah, 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 wah. Wah, wah, wah. Hey, hey, once you go Spanish, it starts to vanish. Who the fuck are the club owners booking Lisa Lampanelli anyway? I don't get the joke. What drug did she give the club owners? The same drug that Jim Mandrinos gave Leanne Lord? This is a throwaway, but Dante is the only bringer that Nick from Stand Up can't rape. If you want to know what happened to Sarge, that's it. Okay. I didn't get to my friend Keith. That was so embarrassing, but I got stuff with Keith. Keith is the only middle with first class upgrade miles on a plane. I've never seen anybody fly so many places as a middle. Keith has helped so many people make it, get ahead. Wait. Keith, fuck with me. Keith has helped so many future celebrities that agents come over his house to see who's sleeping on his couch. Shut up. Here's the last one. It better be good. Or, hey, what are you going to do? Keith MCs so much that even when he headlines, after every joke, he walks off and reintroduces himself. Hey, man, thanks for coming out, man. Y'all been fun. I appreciate it, man. Thank you. Thank you for showing up. this nigga here. Thanks, Savi, for putting this together. Yumi for doing the posters. And thanks, everybody, for coming out, man. Thank you. Appreciate it. I think the after party is at 13, right? 13 or whatever. All right. Thanks, man.
Thank you. Another hand for Patrice O'Neill. You guys are great. Thank you all for coming out.